LumaFusion 4.0 came access to Apple's voice isolation audio filter. This new feature uses machine learning to help you cut down that pesky background noise in your clips. But how well does it actually work? Well, I've got some clips here with me that I shot last week on my travels at one of the noisiest places I could find on the west coast of America. And I brought them with me right here to the LumaTouch office here in Seattle to put the sound isolation feature to the test. Down in San Francisco, I was on a mission to make it to the Golden Gate Bridge, the 1.7 mile long suspension bridge anchored by towers that reach 746 feet skyward. As over 2 billion cars have driven over it to date, I knew it was going to be a loud place. So of course, I grabbed my helmet and headed for the noise. Now I'm recording this video, as you can see, while I'm moving. So the wind coming into my microphone is probably going to be a lot stronger than usual. So let's pause this clip for a second and open up our audio editor in LumaFusion and apply the sound isolation filter. You can see it'll automatically apply 100%. So let's play this clip and adjust the intensity of the filter as the clip is playing, turning it on and off to hear the difference. I'm really intrigued to see how the sound isolation feature fares up, because as videographers, wind is just a nightmare to us. Usually we do not film in the wind. I do have my microphone on though, at all times, as you can see out there. And hopefully it's picking me up quite well. But at the moment, I'm just gonna try to stay on this bike and not fall off. Multitasking is not my strong point, but we'll be at the bridge soon. So you can see there that the sound isolation did a pretty good job at removing the harsh wind that was coming into the mic, but I eventually settled at 74% on the slider as I didn't want to block it out completely. Especially if you're doing something like an action or an activity where the background noise is going to be vital to help you tell your story and to keep the atmosphere of your piece flowing. So make sure every time you add the sound isolation filter, you're not just whacking it up to 100% every single time. It's just important to be aware of that. I've literally just stopped off for a little pit stop, a little bit of a rest, and you can hear in the background there's a bit of construction work going on. Okay, so let's add the sound isolation filter to this clip now. Let's hear how the sound isolation fares with that. Again, we've still got the wind coming into the microphone, but we've also got beeping, we've also got machinery. So let's hope we can get rid of that noise. You can really tell the difference here when you turn the filter on and off by tapping the speaker icon, just how much this filter is working on every frame to reduce the background noise. I'm really happy with this. You know, the construction work and the wind has been massively reduced. It's definitely helped me to hear my voice clearer in this clip. Okay, so using the sound isolation filter on these two clips is definitely helping me feel a bit more confident in tackling those harsh background sounds like wind or noise or construction work that we usually run away from. But now I think it's time to go to the big one, to the noisiest clip I've got. This has, without a doubt, got to be the noisiest place I can find in San Francisco. Okay, now this is just crazy noise. So you can actually see this clip is actually a multicam container on the timeline, because here I used multicam to sync the audio, which I recorded on my phone, to the 360 camera, which I'm holding here in the shot, which I recorded the visuals with. So that's how I did it. But let's add the audio filter now and see how this is going to pan out. There's loads of traffic on both sides of the bridge. There's pedestrians, there's bikes. As you can tell, it's absolutely beautiful. But I'd be really impressed if we can remove some of this noise from the background. Okay, so this is really interesting. A really loud clip with so much audio almost drowning the mic out. By putting the audio filter up to 100%, I almost sounded robotic just then, as it struggles to find my voice in the noise. Now, obviously that isn't the sound I'm going for, so I'm gonna keep that in mind as I adjust the wet dry mix here. This has, without a doubt, got to be the noisiest place I can find in San Francisco. There's loads of traffic on both sides of the bridge. There's pedestrians, there's bikes. As you can tell, it's absolutely beautiful, but I'd be really impressed if we can remove some of this noise from the background. That's much better at 67%, I reckon. Obviously, there's still loud sounds in the background of the traffic, but it's not as bad as the unfiltered clip, and I sound like a human, so that's good. There's so much traffic, it's absolute chaos. There's three rows of cars. Okay, so let's put the sound isolation on our last clip here. on either side of this bridge, so I'll be very impressed if I'm able to reduce this background noise. I am wearing a Rode microphone, it is wireless, so hoping this picks up okay. But yeah, it's absolutely stunning here, as you can tell. But let's all hope you guys can hear me. I got my fingers crossed. I'm actually genuinely impressed at how well the sound isolation audio filter has handled that, because I remember at the time having to almost yell into the microphone, which is not something that you want to do, but the surroundings were just so loud, I had no idea how it was going to turn out. So I'm really happy with that. But I think at this stage now that we've had a few experiments, it's best to go over some of these clips and think about some of the learnings we can take away from those as we go forward with our shooting. Now, I've mentioned it a few times in this video, but it's really important to keep the atmosphere of your clips when you're telling stories in LumaFusion. So don't just apply the sound isolation feature and whack it all the way to the top. Listen to your clip. Make sure that you're keeping those vital sounds that you need to keep in the background in order to keep that atmosphere. Another thing is the importance of using a microphone. Without a microphone, I would not have been able to improve these clips as I did just now. So wireless microphones are great if you're traveling on the go and filming, like say you're in a difficult position as I was. Just make sure you practice with these before you record and your all important interviews, of course. And lastly, don't just rely on this filter. The sound isolation is an amazing tool if you need it, but it's always good practice to ensure you capture quality visuals and audio in the shoot without thinking, oh, I'll just fix it in post-production. So use this tool as and when you need it without relying on it. So with that in mind, now it's time for you guys to go out and experiment with sound isolation for yourself. Maybe you have some clips in your camera roll you can play around with, some interviews, B-roll, pieces to camera, that kind of thing. Or maybe you want to go out like me and actually shoot some fresh content to experiment with. It's always good to test it out before you actually need it for your project. So go and have fun and let us know in the comments how you get on.